subtlety of God by saying this. For example, if you can understand one thing, see, God has created everything. We used to say, we must get a basic idea of what an element is. If something is unintelligible, according to the rule of understanding an object which is unintelligible, unintelligibility or unsuitability is understood by giving exemplification of intelligible substances, and also the difference or the proportional disparity that exists between these two things. For example, if I say that you have your own mother, you know how much she loves you. And if I say that Matru Pitru Sahasraya Bhyopi Vatsaladaram Shastram, the scriptures are having 1,000 times that type of magnanimity, benevolence and affection more than your parents, then you will get an idea. So mother is a perceptible and visible element, and the shastras are imperceptible thing. Whenever things are imperceptible, that imperceptibility is explained to an extent only by giving corresponding status exemplifications of perceptible and visible elements. Likewise, let us explain something. Carbon-carbon bond is there. That is 12 to 50 nanometers. And this double helix DNA structure is there. That is 2 nanometer. And even I'll say something. The tip of a hair, you know how much subtle it is. That is 80,000 nanometers. Then how a nanometer will be? And nanometer, somebody they explained this also. Nanometer, it deals with the size of the nanometer, it can be compared to that of the amount of hair that grows in your face at the time taken for you to take the razor and to keep it before your face. This is how somebody explained. We cannot just keep a nanoparticle and practice this with a razor, but still it shows how minute things are there. By understanding these things, that's how Max Planck, a very famous scholar, he told two statements. One, he told, for scientists, God is at the end, and for religious people, God is at the beginning. Every religious person sees God first, then proceeds with the creation. But no religious person is doing. No religious person is seeing God, then understanding the nature. See, most of the religious people, they are having religion as the shelter for their mistakes or for their problems or solutions. That is, I am talking about absolute scientists and absolute religious votaries. Absolute religious persons, they see divinity in everything, and for them the nature is more understandable than that of the scientists. And scientists, their pursuit is to see the fundamental element, God at last. That is what Max Planck he told. One. Number two, I thought of God something, and I had your faith may be blind. It may be superstitious or it may be rational. But after coming to know about the intricacies, complexities of the world, and the beauty is inside, I started loving God. So I just believed God. That is very different. After understanding the subtleties of the universe, intricacies of universal functions, and the multitudes and the magnitudes on various dimensions, I started loving God. God means it does not be some God which you say that it is in a temple or in a farm. God is absolute phenomenon. It is an absolutic element of purity, hilarity, festivity. It is free from melancholy and it is pure eudaimonia. It is of unconditional love and mercy. It is the substratum for tranquility. And it is the unerring perennial bestower and showerer of prosperity. So that fundamental element. So this is how they define this. Number two, apart from this, there is also a history for these nanoparticles. It started with understanding of atoms and molecules, I told that. Then from the American Physical Society, Dr. Richard Feynman, in the year 1959, he dealt with what I told in ANIMA, that we can manipulate atomic and molecular structures. The same was told by the American Physical Society lecturer, Dr. Richard Feynman. He told that they can be manipulated, and the manipulation systems can be developed. And the second thing, actually, from the Tokyo Science University, Dr. Norio Taniguchi, he dealt with the understanding of atomic structures and the division of atomic particles into further subtlety. And Dr. Erik Dastas, in the year 1987, he dealt with the possibility of getting into nanoparticles by his book known as The Era of Nanotechnology. That was was the first book on nanotechnology. And before getting into that nano, the position of nano, it is a status of a high principle minute system of the atomic structure and status. Before getting that merely atomic studies, molecular studies, and getting into the divisibilities, all these things were pondered, and it was framed, the nomenclature, Namakarana was given by Dr. Ehring. And later on, various things are just gradually, you know, that if something is initiated by somebody, that reflects in the curious minds of the other to deal with the same thing, to get into further depth. But they have resulted in two forms of atomic structure, which is very wonderfully matching with the process of nature. One is the srijana, the process of creation. Second is the process of construction. That is, it is not the process of the construction what we make, it is a process of a reciprocal construction. That is, a linear construction is known as creation and it is clockwise. And a reciprocated system of construction, the second non-linear construction, is also made by Siddha Purushas. They are in nanotechnology known as bottom-up methodology and top-down methodology. So you can construct nanostructures by two methods. One is taking a structure, a basic structure, and allowing the structure to construct itself. That is a phenomenon known as, it is a phenomenon of a molecular adhesion, and it is based on the phenomenon of molecular recognition. So the adhesive nature of each and every molecule with the other, which makes that to construct itself, it is based on the molecular recognition. We used to say this subtler recognition in Punya Papas. यथा धेनु सहस्रेषु वत्सो विन्दति मातरम तथा पूर्वकृतं कर्म कर्तारम अधिगच्छति. एंड ए पर्सन्स विर्चूज एंड सिंस, इन स्पाइट ऑफ द पर्सन्स अवेलेबिलिटी बीइंग मिंगल्ड विद ए वेरी मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ स्पेस एंड मास, इट कैन रियली रिकग्नाइज एंड इट कैन अडहर टू द पर्सन एंड इट कैन इमीडिएटली अप्रोच द पर्सन विदाउट फेइंग और विदाउट एम्बिग्विटी और विदाउट परप्लेक्सिटी. दैट इज द नेचर ऑफ ए पर्सन्स इम्प्रिंट्स, virtuous and evil imprints. Likewise, there is a recognition system among the molecules by which these basic particles, they frame to construct themselves to reach that. It is known as bottom up. And second thing is known as top down. From the top, larger machines or larger structures are taken into account. Just as I have already told about the anima, anima is not the construction process. It is the process of contraction or miniaturization by the process of either a spiritual or scientific temper, which is by a mythical power that is implanted on a device to make it in a miniaturized form. So this is something which is done in the top-down process, in which large level machines, they are contracted, they are miniaturized to the size of a nanoscale. And nano devices, there also the nanoscience consists of two things. One is nanotechnology and second is nanomaterial. Nanomaterials, they deal with the materials which are to that nanoscale, that is 1 to 100 nanometers. This is the scale, the basic molecular structure of 1 to 100 nanoscale. They are taken for consideration in nanomaterial. They are known as nanomaterials separately. And nanotechnology is a process of not only dealing these things, but also fabricating devices which are within that size range. It is not only getting the materials, you know that there are a lot of materials. For example, a microscope is not as equal or as same as the size of a microbe. There is a microscope. The size of the microscope is not as the size of a microbe. There are, for example, there is a cell microscopy is there, then spectroscopy is there. Lot of subtler things are handled in these para-optical or supra-optical vision methodologies, in which the things seen and the size, they are not corresponding or coherent to that of the size of the machinery. But nanotechnology not only deals with the materials, but also it frames the fabrication possibility of the devices within the ambit of the size range of 1 to 100 nanometers. That is the greatest in nanotechnology. And in both of these things, we used to get two microscopes. See, if normally for cells and other tissues we used to get microscopes, a nanoparticle is still more subtle, so it requires a special microscope. One is known as the scanning tunneling microscope, and second is known as the atomic pressure microscope. And it is having two philosophies, two major processing philosophies, and one is epitaxy, and second is lithography. It is an electron beam lithography. lithography and molecular